remember, I started with writing a book about Windows NT 4.0 security, so it had to be a long time ago. First, I started from being regular administrator, doing typical administrator thing, which gives me great experience about how is everything working internally. And then I jump into cybersecurity area, and that's it. I also know a lot of experts not having any administration background. They spend their time on some other areas which are also very valuable, like about the compliance, about the law, about regulations, about management, etc. But they sometimes say, I lack this part of my experience, and at the same time I can say I lack the part related to the law, etc. So any type of the career starting is good to jump into cybersecurity at some point. I'm trying to tell something about traces bad guys can leave within operating systems, within other areas of the information system, possibly allowing us to follow their traces, to document their traces, to find some evidence what they did, and possibly to find them and to make them penalized, I can say, for what they did. Not every single part of the infrastructure is being usually overtaken by hackers, so somewhere some traces are left, and those may be invaluable help for investigators to find those. So it is about different places where traces are left, maybe not very usual, that is another, like I can say, type of knowledge about forensic investigations in computer world, but I will try to touch a couple of those places and explain what we can do about this and how we can act to find them and to make them responsible for their actions. If they want to spend some time within your system, for example, to use it for stealing some data or use it for some other purposes, they prefer to stay invisible, so they are trying to hide their presence. If they jump in, steal something and then jump out, the best way for them is to wipe everything totally, as it wipes traces. So it all depends on their goal. But usually it's about knowing by them about every single breadcrumb they left, and then collect it after they go back. So the key thing is to know more than they know. Collecting it for investigation, for analyzing their traces is one thing. Another thing, if you have some traces and someone went into the system, it can give you a knowledge about what went wrong on your side. As if they could go in, probably it means you have some weaknesses. So it means if you can collect those traces and analyze their path, you have like a perfect path to be fixed, to be improved, as hackers can go this way. Sometimes it's even intentionally made by creating honeypots, luring hackers to do something, to observe their methods, their ways of attacking, etc., to improve your protection. I can say they're a bit too brave, this is quite common, so they are exposing their presence thinking that no one will be able to spot them. This is one of the things that you see. So they are thinking an administrator, the defender is like more stupid than they are. And this is one thing. Another thing is internet is totally international. So let's imagine a scenario when someone from Korea is attacking someone from Russia. Try to find that person, try to do anything. You cannot go to the police in South Korea. You can only go to police forces, law enforcement in Russia. Maybe the cooperation will work somehow, maybe not. And if the infrastructure for attacking is spread, let's say, over 20 countries, you are out of luck. And we saw such cases. Even if like FBI was involved into performing the investigation, they had to ask for help, like US law enforcement, Italian law enforcement, Canada law enforcement, Ukrainian one, and so on and so on. And sometimes the quality of the help those law enforcement is providing to the coordinator of the investigation is really poor. If you think they can actively do something wrong, blocking it totally is definitely the best thing, as you will stop them at the same time. Let's imagine hackers going through some remote connection to Swift subsystem within the bank. So breaking the cable connection is the best thing you can do. Otherwise, it may be way more smarter to collect the evidence to prove their presence in the system. If they are not active, not acting directly against you within the same moment, then the priority should be preserving the evidence. Very simple example. You see within your system some very suspicious process, probably left by hackers, and you can see it is something wrong with this process. It's so human, it's so tempting to kill the process. At the same time, if you kill the process, you free the memory this process owns. So right now, the operating system starts to zero the memory process occupied a moment ago, and all traces are gone. All sockets, all handles to files, all data process kept within the memory. If you suspend the process is not active anymore, but it's still present within the memory. Very tiny difference, at the same time, the critical in terms of investigation. So it's about good practices.